Welcome to the Holly Area Community Show. I'm here with Joy Becker at the Holly Public Library. And we're here to talk about some things that are going to be happening in the upcoming seasons, and now we're into spring. So what's going on at the library?
We have some exciting things coming up this spring, Jody. Zachary Scott Johnson is going to be here to talk about the evolution of pop music on May 4th at 6:30. He's going to talk about how folk and country and jazz and classical music have all combined to create various different popular songs.
Wow, and so is he from the area, or where's this man from?
He is from, he's a songwriter from Minnesota. I don't recall the exact town.
Okay.
But all of our legacy events focus on artists throughout Minnesota.
Okay.
So we recently had the Minnesota Crime Wave in. They're from, most of them are from Minneapolis, but William Kent Krueger was here to talk about mystery writing.
Wow.
It's fantastic
fun.
Stuff.
Fun. Yeah, yes. That sounds like fun.
Yeah. And then Candace Zimmer will be here on May 18th at 6:30, and she's a historical fiction author of Abercrombie Trail and Pomme de Terre. She also writes a lot of poetry, so she'll be talking about writing poetry and historical fiction, mostly set in Minnesota.
Oh, so when is that event?
That is on Wednesday, May 18th at 6:30.
Okay.
And then we've got a really exciting artist reception. I'm so excited. The Holly High School art students have been working on a mural for our children's area this school year.
Within the library,
within
a mural.
The library. Yep.
Okay.
It's a permanent mural for our children's area, and we'll be unveiling it on June 1st at 5 with an artist reception for them. So I hope folks will come and have some dessert and meet the artists. And
you know, I think I did read about that in the paper, and that I had interviewed the art teacher at the high school, Tara Hager, and they seem to have such a great program going there. So
yes.
That's really neat to have that partnership with them.
They have some phenomenal artists.
Yes, they do.
It's going to be great. And then if folks are around for that, I hope they'll stick around for Eric Bergeson's presentation that same evening at 6:30.
Oh, he's always a local favorite, Eric.
He is.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to be talking about life down on the farm.
So yeah.
It'll be fun.
Sure.
We also have our monthly book discussion going on the second Wednesday of every month. This month in May, we'll be talking about Haunted Ground by Aaron Hart. And next month, we'll be talking about How Starbucks Saved My Life.
Oh, so are these fiction books, nonfiction, or?
We read a variety. The Haunted Ground is a fiction.
Okay.
And How Starbucks Saved My Life is a nonfiction.
Okay.
This summer we'll be reading a junior adult novel, and we'll be reading a kind of heavier Latin American novel later this summer.
Wow.
Yeah.
So do you select these books, or do you get input from people?
We get
or?
A lot of feedback. The group is pretty informal, so we try to pick a variety of different books because some folks might like one and not want to come the next month, which is just fine. We're real informal. It's a lot of fun. We try to read across a broad spectrum of genres. And we get a lot out of the book when we discuss it. We kind of go back and revisit parts, and having someone else's thoughts on where the book came from and what was happening is really great.
Oh, that sounds fun. So you meet, you said weekly?
Monthly.
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 Okay, so you read the book and then you meet, correct?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
One time.
One time.
Gotcha. Oh, yeah. That sounds like fun.
Yeah, it is fun. If anyone is interested, I would hope that they would let me know. And if they read a book that they think is great for discussing, let me know.
Yeah, okay.
We also have a monthly program called Armchair Travelers Novel Destinations. They're programs that are presentations given by local tour guides, we call them, folks that have been different places and are willing to share their stories and pictures of their travels.
Oh, fun, you know, and I can think offhand some people that I would love to hear about their travels, because we've got some in the community.
Some great folks. It's so much fun. It's very informal. Last month, Audrey Gerhardson talked about her travels to Pakistan, and it was so funny. She had these great anecdotes. This month, we'll be traveling to Guatemala with Lynn Johnson.
Wow.
Yeah. And then Fred Herring is going to talk about the Dutch East Indies in June.
Yeah, I was going to mention Fred. I thought, I bet you he'd be willing
yes.
to share. Oh,
he was
that
very
would be
excited.
Interesting. Yes.
I'm pretty excited about that.
Yeah.
And then we always have our preschool story time on Fridays at 10:30. And we've got a fun after-school activity on May 12th at 4 for the students. Lego night.
So Lego night.
Lego night.
Who doesn't love Legos? But this is just for, did you say preschool?
No, this is for students.
Students.
After school. So mostly geared to elementary students.
Gotcha.
But bring themselves and a friend, and we'll have the Legos, so we don't have to worry about getting everyone's Legos mixed up.
Okay. Oh,
but
smart.
It's great fun.
Oh, okay. Well, let's take a little break, because we still have a season to go. We're going to talk about summer events, so we'll be right back. And we're back with Joy Becker at the Holly Public Library, actually a branch of the Lake Agassiz Regional Library,
right? That's right.
I wanted to throw that in because you're a part of a bigger system.
That's right.
Yes. So let's talk about the summer, because everyone wants to think about the summer, so we might as well talk about some of the summer activities at the library.
All right. We have our usual summer reading program, and I am so excited this year. Our theme is One World, Many Stories.
One World, Many Stories.
Yeah. So we're bringing in things from all over the world. For the kids, we've got a Taekwondo presentation. We've got a circus arts demonstration. We're going to do a reader's theater. We're going to make recycled monster creatures.
Oh, wow. Yes. How big are these monsters going to be?
As big as the kids want to make
them. Whoa, okay.
So that should be
interesting.
Fun.
Interesting.
Yes. We'll have a puppet show, and we'll do some luggage relays and some other fun events.
Oh.
That will all revolve around that One World, Many Stories.
So where do you get these ideas? Are they all swirling around in your head, or do you have, within your system, do you swap ideas?
We do. We do. Yeah. There's a region-wide theme that's given out, and we get a lot of ideas from collaborating with other libraries through the system. And then we get together with our regional library and collaborate, and some of the things we come up with on our own. So
it's
kind of a nice
mix. So you
can
be a little creative, but you can also have some support from the bigger system.
Yeah, and it's great. Mm-hmm. I was collaborating with a local teacher who's going to be helping us out with the teen program, and she's going to be doing a food, fun, and film event for the teens that hopefully will be ongoing throughout the summer to help the kids learn a little bit of Spanish in a fun setting.
Oh, fun. And who's this teacher?
Bridget Hall.
I know Bridget Hall. Oh, she's great.
Yeah, she's
that will
so
be fun.
Enthusiastic.
Yes, she is.
We're also going to do some Mancala tournaments and henna painting and visit a former Peace Corps officer for the teens. So I think that'll be very interesting for kids who want to get out there and get involved.
Yeah. Oh, that's great.
And our adult programs, of course, will be continuing our armchair traveler programs and our book discussions and various computer classes. And our knitters and handcrafters meet throughout the summer. They meet every Wednesday from 6 to 8.
Oh, okay. So people, they just come here and knit and
visit.
And no particular project, just their own projects.
Yeah. And it's kind of nice because if they're having trouble on a particular thing, they tend to help each other out and get tips.
And what a beautiful space to do it in. It's so comfortable and nice in the library.
Yes, it is very fun.
Yeah.
And they just get along so great.
Good.
I am also excited. Mark Peel's going to be back this summer to do a presentation for us on Clay County Historic Ghost Towns.
Oh, wow.
Yes, he's from the Historical Society of Clay County.
And so he was here last summer, you said?
He actually was here last fall. He did some genealogy classes for us.
Oh,
and talked about the resources available. So.
Yeah. Oh, interesting.
He's so fun to listen to.
Yeah. Well, thank you.
Yeah.
So you've got a lot going on. How do you accomplish this? Do you have a staff? Do you have volunteers to help you? Or is it just you?
We have a lot of volunteers that help. We couldn't do the programs without them. And we do have some support staff that helps out. So I'm not manning the place by myself when we're doing all these programs. But we do need a lot of volunteers to carry out these programs, especially like the armchair traveler programs are put on all by volunteers. And the summer reading program takes a lot of people and time to do. It's not something you'd have to help with for every event. Like sometimes folks are like, oh, I really love Reader's Theater, so they might want to help out with that one event. Mm-hmm. And that's just great. We need folks like that.
Sure.
So
if someone had an interest in the library or reading or want to share their travels, I'm assuming they would just come and talk to you,
just
right?
Come and talk to me and we can put something together or see where you fit.
Oh, that sounds wonderful. Yeah. So, anything else, maybe, I know technology is changing all the time. How about in this library? What's going on in that vein?
Well, we talked a little bit about the self-check computer last time that's sitting
here
behind us.
How is that going?
It's going well. People seem to be really excited about it.
They can just check the book out themselves.
They can bring their library card in, scan it, scan the books, and off they go. Which is nice. But we've also got something else I'm really excited about. Do you have an e-reader?
I do not. You mean like an electronic
reading device?
Yep. Like a Kindle or
a Nook?
Or a Nook?
Mm-hmm.
I do not, but I've been looking at them.
Well, I'm very excited. The library is offering OverDrive software now, which you can download books for free to your Kindle, not to your Kindle yet, rather, to your Nook or other e-readers. You can do it with your iPad, your iPhone.
Oh my goodness, so people can just download this free. And does it take a lot is it difficult to do? Or
it's not really. The first couple of times it might be a little bit tricky. There's a little bit of software, of course, that you need to download to get it to work properly in your system. But I've done it a couple of times. It works really slick, especially after you've got it set up. There's thousands of titles, and they'll be adding more as they find out how popular it is.
Well, things are ever changing here, and I thank you so much for joining us, and I'm sure after this summer we'll check you out again, see what's going on in the fall.
Thank you, Jody.
Until next time.